Open the eyes of I'm
just magnify. Can we just stand on our feet and just magnify? And just give God praise and just come on and just clap our hands. Just let the Lord hear the sound of your voice.
I feel it all over me.
doors could have been shut, but God. A lot of people could have been in their grave, but God. I said, but God. But God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, you ain't got to have everything you want. Just have everything you need. Come on and give them a praise. Hallelujah. God has blessed you with everything you need. Come on and just give them a praise. Hallelujah. I don't see no wheelchairs in here. I don't see no oxygen tanks in here. Hallelujah. You are the praise of God. Hallelujah. The Lord is our shepherd. I said, the Lord is our shepherd. And we shall not know. Amen. We're going to change the order of the service. Hallelujah, but praise is coming among us. Amen. Praise is our calling card. When we greet one another, we say, praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. People should know us by our praise. People should know us by our worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, I'm going to move on. But I told a preacher yesterday, you know, a preacher don't know how to move on. They keep saying they're going to move on, but just stay right there. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. But I was telling somebody the other day, you know, when we get together, when the saints of God get together, the atmosphere changes. The anointing increases. The power of God is elevated in the place. Why? Because when two or three are gathered in His name, and the Lord shows up, don't you feel it in this place? I said, don't you feel it in this place? Did you bring a witness back from Osaka? Did you enter His gates with thanksgiving? Did you come to His courts with praise? Amen. So as we get ready to go before the Lord, we want to see if there's any prayer requests. Amen. If you have a particular prayer request, you can stand now and let it be known. Amen. Hallelujah. Continue to pray for the Clark and Arrington family, that the Lord will bless them in a mighty way. Thank you, Jesus. And all of us that may be grieving and going through. Amen. Amen. Sister Kimmy. Praise the Lord. Yes. 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 Amen. Somebody say yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you. Deacon Fields. Get things right. Amen. Because we don't know how much time we have. Amen. And it's time for us to get things right. Amen. Hallelujah. I was attending that particular service on yesterday, and I was looking at the people, and in their faces, you could see that, you know, of the multitude of deaths that they've experienced, that they were tired. Amen. So let us pray for them. God is a recovery God. Amen. God is a recovery God. All right. Any other prayer requests? Thank you, Jesus. Pray for the success of the service on today. There's something to be said and done to encourage us, to inspire us. Amen. I want to be inspired. Don't you want to be inspired? I want to come up higher. Don't you want to come up higher? Alicia, I see you. You want to come up higher. Me and your dad were talking about you yesterday. Hallelujah. Come up higher. Hallelujah. Come up higher in the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Let the church stand. We want to ask Minister Quinn if he'll come lead us into prayer.
Praise Him. Start with verse 12.
Not as though I have already obtained, either was already perfect, but I follow after that I may apprehend that from which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, and reaching forth unto those things which are before. It says, I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ. You know, if you just keep on living, there's going to be times when you're feeling blue. There's going to be times when you feel like nobody wants to be around. There'll be times when you feel like crying and even dying. But you just got to keep on remembering these words. Forget those things which are behind. And reach towards the mark of the prize of the high call of God in Christ Jesus. Pray my spirit.
Oh,
just forget about your condition. Just focus on the King of Kings. Whom the Lord has set free. Worship in this atmosphere. There's healing in this atmosphere. The Spirit of the Lord is in this place. Just worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him for deliverance. Worship Him for glory. All together, You're worthy. You're wonderful. Yeah, I'll never. Unto the Lord for all His benefits. The Bible says we shall take up the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, we thank You in this atmosphere. Lord, we thank You for Your goodness and Your mercy. We thank You for the love that You have shown toward us. Lord, we thank You that You chose us, that You justified us, that You sanctified us. Lord, that You brought us out of darkness into Your marvelous light. We thank You, Lord, for this space to worship You. We thank You, Lord, for this opportunity, Lord, just to bow before You, just to give You glory, just to give You honor, just to give You praise. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. And come on, shout. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Lord, You are great, and You're greatly to be praised. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Come on and give the Lord a praise. Come on and just give the Lord a praise. Come on and just forget about yourself. Forget about your condition. Just give the Lord a praise. Just say, Lord, I thank You. 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 Lord, I want to thank You. I want to thank You for Your mercy. I want to thank You for Your grace. I want to thank You for Your power. Oh, I thank You. Oh, because the blood still works. I said the blood still works. Thank You for the blood of Jesus. Oh God, we thank You. Hallelujah. 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 The Bible says we're two or three are gathered together in His name. He said, I'll be in the midst. The Lord is in the midst of us. Hallelujah. I said, the Lord is in the midst of us. I said, the Lord is in the midst of us. Hallelujah. He's here to heal us. He's here to deliver us. He's here to strengthen us. Jesus said, come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Hallelujah. We have entered into his presence. We have entered into his gates. Oh Lord, we thank you in this place. We magnify you in this place. Lord, we give you glory in this place. Lord, we ask you, Lord, to bless us in this place. Strengthen us in this place. Revive us in this place. Lord, you are our shepherd, and we shall not walk. Lord, you restore our soul. You renew our heart. Lord, you renew our anointing and promotion. You renew our power. You renew your glory. Give us a fresh anointing. 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 Let come out, shut. Let come out, shut. Let come out, shut. Let come out, shut. Where are my tongue talkers? I need somebody to talk to Jesus. I need somebody to call on the name. Call on the name. Call on the name. Let God have a shot, God have a shot. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we glorify you. Lord, we magnify you in this world. Hey, Lord, if I had 10,000, tell them all the praises. I tell them all the praises. I tell them all the praises. I realize my breakthrough is in my praise. I realize my healing is in my praise. I realize that my strength is in the praise. Oh, your healing is in the praise. Your breakthrough is in the praise. Your strength is in the praise. All that men would praise him. Praise him because he's good. Praise him because he's marvelous. Praise him because he's wonderful. Praise him because he is God. Oh, there's nobody else like him. You ought to praise him. Praise him. Praise ye the Lord. Tell somebody, praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Thank the Lord that you saw another day. Oh, the Lord has kept me.
It's just another day that the Lord has kept me. He's kept me from all evil. He's kept me from all evil. The devil had desired to sift you as wheat, but he kept you from all evil. Oh, with your mind stayed on him. Oh God, we thank you. We praise you in this atmosphere. We worship you in this atmosphere. We give you glory in this atmosphere. We glorify you. We magnify you. We thank you. There is none like you, Lord, in all the earth. Hallelujah. Tell somebody there's none like you in all the earth. Tell your soul, soul, take courage. Because there's none like him in all the earth. Tell your soul, soul, don't faint. There's no one like him in all the earth. Tell your soul, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Tell your soul, I would have paid unless I believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Tell your soul, old soul, magnify. Magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name. His name is Jesus. I said his name is Jesus. There's healing in the name of Jesus. There's deliverance in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. There's strength in the name of Jesus. There is joy in the name of Jesus. Come on and just give him a praise. Come on and just give him a praise. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Come on and just give the Lord a hand. Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. Hallelujah. You know, that praise is good for me, but just come on and give the Lord a praise. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. He kept you. I said, he kept you. Hallelujah. Minister Benny, just give me your hand for a minute. You know what I'm doing? I'm touching a miracle. I said, I'm touching a miracle. I said, I'm touching a miracle. God don't believe me like that. I'm touching a miracle. God snatched them from the hands of death. I'm touching a miracle. He was facing death in the ICU, but God, somebody say, but God, he's got a little shot. Somebody say, but God, but God, but God, but God, he's a miracle worker. He's a miracle worker. He's a miracle worker. I can go home today and say, I touched a miracle. You can go home today. I see the miracle working business that God is still in. Tell somebody he's a miracle worker. If I were to call Stanley, Stanley would say he's a miracle worker. Oh, you ought to give God a praise. You ought to give God a praise. And let God know I thank you. I thank you for being a miracle worker. I thank you for being a mind regulator. I thank you for being a very present in the time of trouble. I thank you for being my healer. I thank you for being my deliverer. I thank you for being I say he's a miracle worker. What's his name? What's his name? What's his name? What's his name? His name is Jesus. Sister Cora, is he a miracle worker? Just look at her. God has renewed her. God has restored her. He's a miracle worker. Let's have a shout. Hallelujah! 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 You don't know like I know. I don't know like you know what the Lord has done for you. Morning, Keith. If this the Glover could be here today, he'll tell you he's a miracle worker. All right, come on, give the Lord a praise. Woo! Somebody say, I got a praise. I got a praise. And I got to get it out. Oh, God, I got a praise. Hallelujah. I ain't going to exit video on you. I ain't going to act like I got it all together. Hey! Hallelujah. I'm one trial from falling in. But my foot was almost put to sleep. I say, but God. Somebody say, but God. When the devil thought he had you, but God. Oh, when he tried to destroy you, but God. But God. But God. You ought to give him a prayer. Send out of us. Hallelujah. You can look at that butt as being a powerful conjunction, or you can look at that butt as being a powerful transition. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A transition to something great. A transition into something new. A transition into something powerful. Because if God orders something, if it had not been for the Lord, oh God, we got to move on. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, come on, just give me one more praise. Hallelujah. We thank God for our First Lady. Come on, give God a praise for her. Hallelujah. We thank God for the Crosby's elder around the Crosby's. Amen. We thank God for Mrs. Queen. Mr. Greatest Day is my miracle man. I'm going to call you my miracle man. Hallelujah. Because God is a miracle worker. Thank God for Mother Davis, amen. We thank God for all the Christian ministries, amen. Our deacons, amen. We thank God for our sound people. We thank God for all of our visitors here today. We thank God for everybody. Amen. Everybody is somebody because Jesus is the reason why. Amen. Amen. So we thank God for each and every one of you as we change this order of our service. Amen. We thank God for the Daniels bringing the baby on today. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He's wonderful. And we're going to thank God for our new baby being born. Amen. From the Kennedys. Amen. On this week. I didn't know she was going in on this week, but the Lord had me still go over there and pray for her. Any good? Any good to be obedient? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. Thank you, Lord. We thank God for Christian Ministries of the Apostolic Faith Church. Amen. Where our vision is to be a caring fellowship, leading souls to Christ, strengthening members and families, making disciples, equipping them for service and community ministry. Amen. Some people may say, well, why did you move from that place to this place so that we can really fulfill our mission? Amen. What God has given us to be a community service in the community. Amen. Thank you, Jesus, to help others, to bring souls to Christ. Amen. To love of all people so that people may see and know that there is a God. Amen. Come on, somebody. Aren't you glad that you're a part of the vision that God has given to you? And our purpose is literally to promote the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. We want to promote that gospel, don't we? Every opportunity, we want to lift up the name of Jesus. Amen. And give God glory. And we thank God and praise God for each and every one of you that have come out to be with us. Amen. In this great service. So as far as our announcements goes, amen, on this coming end of the month, September. Ooh, I don't want to go backwards. Amen. How many of you want to go backwards? And Deacon Pia said, I'm forgetting those things that I've had. Amen. Amen. I'm pressing. Amen. I'm reaching for those things that are before me. Amen. And I'm pressing toward that mark. Thank you, Jesus. He just had a little sermonette up here when he did that. I was like, okay, go ahead. Thank you, Jesus. But on October 29th and October 30th, we're going to have our 19 States Council program. Amen. And on that, I'm going to hand out the flyers on next week so that you would have them. But on that Friday, we have Bible study by Secretary Bishop Elect Darrell Fair. He'll be doing Bible study at 3 p.m. Amen. At 11 a.m., we have our evangelism and outreach group. Amen. And then we have our global missions at 1 p.m. And then at 3 p.m., we'll have our Bible study. And then at 7 p.m., we'll have our very own district elder designate, Marilyn Mathis. She'll be the evening speaker. And then on that Saturday, amen, somebody say Saturday. On that Saturday, our youth department will be in charge, and the King of Tennessee will be the speaker for that particular program, and that starts at 11 a.m. And then at 1 p.m. we'll have Christian education. At 3 p.m. will be church development. Then at 7 p.m., we have our speaker for the hour. That would be our very own Pastor Beverly Renford out of Rochester, New York. And old school, not a stop. Thank you, Jesus. And we thank God for her and her ministry and what God is doing in her life. You know, when I was talking to her on the phone, we was in a Zoom meeting, and gave her some words of expression I was going to be reading. And just her words, when she spoke, you just feel the life of it. And as she was speaking, I just felt the anointing. Thank you, Lord. Coming through, I said, my God. Isn't it good to feel the anointing? Isn't it good to feel the words? Hallelujah. I'm going to take that stuff for granted. God is good. So let us govern ourselves. All of this is virtual. Hopefully it'll be our last virtual meeting this year, and then we'll go to live meetings according to the will of God. Amen. Get this pandemic under control. Amen. Amen. So all right, that concludes our announcements, and we certainly thank God for each and every one of you. And right now we want to change the order of service on today. Somebody says blessing time.
Blessing time.
And what time is it?
Blessing
time. Amen. It's blessing time in the sanctuary. Amen. We want to ask our deacons to come forward. Amen. Amen. Doesn't he look wonderful? He came in and they caught my attention. Amen. Looking sharp, looking nice. Amen. Looking good. He's going to say it's Easter soon. Jesus. Oh, man. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. You know why they're picking on him? Because he picked on them. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. What did he say? Oh, amen. Amen. So we want the church to stand. Hey, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And let us pray. Gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we certainly thank you for this opportunity to give.
and to sow seed into the kingdom. Lord, we ask you to bless each and every soul in this hero today. Magnify your glory. Magnify your power. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Come on and bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord with me.
Routinely
went to the temple to pray. If we were to study history, we would find out that they literally prayed three times a day. They prayed at 9 a.m., they prayed at noon, and they prayed at the ninth hour, which is 3 p.m. What is significant about 3 p.m. was 3 p.m. was the offering of the sacrifice. That's when they offer the sacrifice. And what makes that significant to you and I is that Jesus is our sacrifice. And at 3 p.m., that's when he literally hung his head and died and said, "It is finished." 3 p.m. They went up, Peter and John. They went up as prayer partners. And when they went up to pray, we see that they were unlikely prayer partners. Peter was hot-tempered. He was a man that really went off the easy, if you say, and got upset and got angry. But John, he was more of a lover. He was more of a peaceful man. But what brought these two uncommon people together is Jesus. Jesus is the commonality between all of us. And the Lord said to me as I was studying and getting ready for this sermon, he said, "Now that's unity. Being able to lay aside your differences for a common cause." What more better reason to lay down our differences for a common cause to magnify the name of the Lord? To magnify the name of the Lord. The Bible says how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Let us be unified and magnify the name of the Lord. And I thank God for their unity, because they went into the temple not to gossip, but they went into the temple to pray. They went into the temple to give God glory and to magnify his holy name. Be sure when you choose a prayer partner that your prayer partner has the same agenda as you, to give God glory and to magnify the name of the Lord. So they, as they went into the temple, the Bible says they went into an eastern gate entrance called the gate, the beautiful gate. And at that particular gate, there was a gate that was bronze, and it was magnificent. It was ornate, if you allow me to say it. In that particular area, there were the Gentiles who went into the temple to pray. And the women went into the temple to pray. And at this particular time, the Bible says there was a certain man that was laid or carried there daily and laid at the gate. They were there carried and laid at the gate because he himself couldn't work himself. The Jews had an obligation to take care of those that couldn't help themselves or couldn't take care of themselves. And they were, so to speak, what we would call our welfare system to take care of those that couldn't take care of themselves. And while he was there, laid at that gate, they carried them daily there. And that brings us to another point that you know, they carried him there. They carried him there, which means that they were bearing his burdens. They were bearing his burdens. Ought not we ought to bear one another's burdens? Ought not we to help one another when we see that they need help? Ought we not to help one another, to help bear one another's burdens? You know, I don't believe that they were talking about him. I don't believe that they were pointing fingers at him. I don't believe that they were laughing at him. I believe that they brought him there so that he could receive help. How many of you know that your help is in the house of God? How many of you know that your help is in the house of the Lord? You know, we used to call the house of the Lord, the hospital. We used to call the hospital, Lord, the clinic where you can get your healing, where you can get your deliverance, where you can receive the help that you need. And while they brought that man there daily at that gate, and he, Peter and John were walking in, and they saw Peter and John, and he got his attention and said, why don't you give us some alms and give me some alms and give me something that will help me. Alms is, if you look at that word and look it up, it means to give compassion to. To give compassion to. And you know, I just got to talk about, can I just talk just a little bit? We're going to get to the message, but you know, I get excited when the Lord reveals things to me. Because, you know, it was at that place where Jesus had questioned about the giving of alms, because there were some people that were coming and giving for the wrong reason. They were coming to give so that they can be seen of men just before they entered into the kingdom or entered into the temple, so that God would give them some special applause, so that God would give them a special attention. And that's where Jesus picked that thing up in the book of St. Matthew and said, you ought to give your alms in secret, where God, who sees you in secret, can reward you openly. My God, Jesus, he's a bad somebody. Hallelujah. He said, you need to take the opportunity and stop trying to be seen while you're giving, and do your giving in secret. Stop trying to embarrass people. Stop trying to get your name up in lights. Hallelujah. If you want your name up in lights, let God pull you up. Let God lift you up. Just humble yourself beneath the mighty hand of God. And these individuals, they were laid at the gate to get their welfare money, if you allow me to say it, to get some help, to get some aid. That was their culture. Their culture was to help one another. Doesn't that sound like our culture? That we should help one another. That we should bear one another's burdens. That we should do unto others. Oh God, who am I talking to here today? As we would have them to do unto us. And on this particular time, my God, he was there, and Peter and John, they walked by. They just came off of a dynamite meeting, you know. They just came from a dynamite service on the day of Pentecost when the Holy Ghost fell. And Peter preached a dynamic service on that particular day with souls above. Bible says above 3,000 souls got saved. 3,000 souls got baptized. And he had a message. He said, repent ye, every one of you, and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. So, oh God, and they was filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. So I believe Peter and John, they was on fire when they came out of that revival meeting on the day of Pentecost and walked up to that man. That man asked him a question, and Peter looked on him and said, look on us. He said, silver and gold have we none, but such as we have, give we unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. He said, rise up and walk. You see, Peter, my God, although he was anointed, he was broke. How many know you can be anointed and broke? But if you're anointed, and you possess Christ, you have all things. Oh my God, you can do all things through Christ that strengthens you. And Peter said to the individual, that silver and gold have I none. And he was letting them know that, you know, I see that there's an obligation for me to help you with. And I don't have any silver, and I don't have any gold, but he said, such as I have, my God, he said, such as I possess, or such as been entrusted with me. Oh my God, he said, in the name, how do you know there's power in the name? inheritance in the hand. He said, but such as I have, such as been entrusted to me, such as been has given unto me. He said, in the name of Jesus, he grabbed him and said, rise up and walk. You know, there's power in the name of Jesus. There's deliverance in the name of Jesus. And you know that the Lord, he entrusts this power unto you. And that power is exerted when you call on that name. My God, that power is released when you call on that name. You know, the Bible says that God has put our treasures in earthen vessels, my God. And when we receive the Holy Ghost, when we receive that power from the Holy Ghost, God, he indwells in us. He gives us something and he entrusts in us. My God, the Bible says that when you receive the Holy Ghost, you were sealed unto the day of redemption. You were sealed with something that's magnificent. You were sealed with some great anointed power. And that power that he has given unto you, you've got to realize that it's transferable, my God. When you touch somebody in the name of Jesus, you can transfer the power that is in Christ that's working through you. Oh, my God, I will get that on your way home. My God, when you use the name of Jesus, it releases an anointing. It releases some power. My God, and that power that is released, it worketh in you. My God, and that man was healed. The Bible said that immediately his feet and his ankle bones, they received strength. How many know that this power that God has given unto us is powerful? Oh God, and people, when you use the name of Jesus, they can receive strength. Oh God, they can receive strength. That's why you need to be walking around and calling on the name. The Bible says that there is no other name given unto heaven whereby men must be saved other than the name of Jesus. Oh God, you've got to realize that there's deliverance, that there's joy, that there's power in the name. You see, the devils have to back up when you call on that name. Sickness has to release when you call on that name. Oh God, the atmosphere can change when you call on that name. You see, when he calls on the name of Jesus and transferred that power unto that lame and crippled man, the Bible says immediately. Oh, somebody says immediately. Immediately his feet and his ankle bones received strength. And then he got up. Oh, tell somebody that the name of Jesus, it can get you up. It can get you up out of a lame situation, a lame condition, and give you power to leap and walk and praise your God. Somebody say power. Power. Somebody say power. Power to live right. Power to do right. Power to come and shout. Power to call on that name. Oh, clap your hands and give God a praise. God, and give God a praise. Oh, I'm almost finished here. You see, Peter and John, oh, when they called on the name of Jesus, they transferred the power that was in him unto that name and helped glorify the name of the Lord. You see, Jesus, oh, you see, Peter, he wasn't trying to glorify himself. Oh, he wasn't trying to make a name for himself. He was trying to make a name for Jesus. For the Bible says, if I be lifted up, I'll opposition in the name of Jesus.
So I say I'm gonna drive my Pinto, and
And I'm not going to take the Cadillac. Not because I don't want people to see what God is able to do. No! Hallelujah! Put on the name! Somebody say, Rod, baby, Rod! I'm coming in the name of Jesus! Amen. Lord, here I have my pool next week, and y'all expect a good altar call.